than I am. And he said, oh my goodness. And he came to his senses. Sometimes things have to happen for you to come to your senses. And you sitting here praying, God, is this the right relationship for me? Or saying, there's some of you that won't pray, is God, is this the right relationship? Is this the right job? Is it, am I supposed to live here? Am I supposed to go there? Because it's what you want. And so we don't pray at all because you know God's going to say no. You know he's going to answer you. You know, you don't want to pray. You're running like Jonah. You're just running as far as you can. And you find yourself swallowed up in a whale. But that's another story. But with that said, we've been there. You don't want to hear his voice. He said, acknowledge you in all of his ways and he'll direct your path. So here is this piece. He came to his senses. And he says, wow, my father's servants are eating better than I am. He didn't come back to God cocky. He didn't come back to God arrogant. He didn't come back. He realized something was missing. Torment was there because he had separated himself from his covering, from his father, from the only thing that really, truly loved him, with or without anything. He didn't have to do anything for this love. It was given him. He walked away from this love. He walked away from the house. He walked away from the covering. He walked away and he spent. So he had to take ownership, not God. You know, I don't know about you, but you know, there's a blame thing that we inherited from Adam and Eve. So you want to blame it was your parents' fault that I'm in this situation. It's my ex's fault. And if this had lost this job, this wouldn't have happened. You're blaming the spouse and you're blaming, it's the woman you gave me. And it's this, it's the man you gave me. And you know what? If this hadn't happened, I wouldn't be in this situation. And I'm mad at God. I'm mad at everybody else. And you're not really looking at self and saying, it's me. I put myself in this situation. When his son came to the father, he decided, I'm going to go back and I'm going to turn. First, it requires a turning from where you're at. I don't want to be here because this is the road of destruction. He realized nothing good was on that road he was on, and it was only going to get worse. He's working for somebody he doesn't want to work for. He's doing what he doesn't want to do. He's a slave to sin. He's like, no, I got to go back to the father. The prodigal son made a decision to leave his father, and now he made a decision to turn back to his father. We've all left and chose something else from for God. We've chosen sex. We've chosen money. We've chosen jobs that he said don't take. We've chosen, I don't care if God said, I want you, you know what? I want you to go lose some weight. You decide, I don't want to do that right now. I've done it. No, I've been like, no, I just want to eat this. And you'd be like, no. I don't think it's good for you. Whatever it is, we make all these decisions that we've chosen things that God said not to choose. So he came back to the father and he said, Father, I have sinned against heaven and I've sinned against you. What I love is the prodigal son accepted total responsibility for his distance. He didn't try to blame anybody else. So this is the point where he had fully admitted that he had failed, that he knew he was not even worthy to accept what God had for him. So he was willing just to take a job. He didn't come back in like, okay, I want my bed, I want my room, I want everything you have for me. Give me my car back, give me what I have back. No, he came in a low position. Like, look, I'll take a paid position. I'll just come and work my way up if I could just be close to you. The Father was so amazing. And this is the God that you have. And this is the God that you serve. He knew you were gonna make the mistake before you even did. He already planned. The district, like he, if you're trying to go to Oregon, and you're on I-5 going south, you're not going to get there from here. I don't care what you do, if as long as you're going on I-5 south, you got to go turn and go to I-5 north. Now, you might have found out you were on the wrong road when you got to San Diego, and you turned around, made a U-turn to start going towards I-5 north, but the good news is you're not going in the wrong direction anymore. So there has to be a turning. It might take you a little bit longer to get back to where you were, but the good news is you're on the right path. You're on the right direction. And that's what God wants. He said, you might be far off. I've been far off. Yeah. I went far off. Yeah. Oh my goodness. I'm going to tell you, right before I really got saved, so I don't know about you guys, but you know, I had to really, really get saved because there was a time when I really wasn't saved. There was a time where I came to church, I played around with God, and I was in and out. I really thought I was in love with him, but I wasn't in love with him. I had a strong like, and there's a lot of that. And we pick and choose our yeses. I pick and choose if I'm going to obey. pastors go to church 2, 3, 4, 20 years and are not in real relationship with God, intimacy with God. Say yes to God, no matter what it takes. You know what? Some people say, well, God, if you get me out of the situation, I'm going to serve you. And you know what? There's a whole group of people that will die, live, will let them cut your head off, and they don't care. He doesn't need to make your deals because he's got some real people who really love him. And they will hold out, and they will say no. They will deny their flesh. They will deny their stuff. He wants the real thing. You don't want to have be married to somebody that kind of chooses you sometimes. I'm going to be with you a little bit. I'm going to be with you on this day, but when something better comes along, then I'll come back and see you. You want somebody that's fully committed every single day, that no matter what somebody plots in front of them, that they're not going nowhere because they are totally committed to you. That's the God that we serve. He said, I want your whole heart. I want all of you. I don't want your deals. I don't want your money. I want you. And so when you turn, he loves you so much, he gives all of himself. You ever seen somebody just give their all? He gave his only begotten son. He sent his son to die on the cross for us. He gave it all up for you and me. And he said, will you do the same for me? Be joined to me. Be committed. Be dedicated on your good days and on your bad days. Just be with me. So this father, when he is father, I'm going to tell you, I was so far off on my way right before I really got saved. I'm going to tell you, keep it real. I was Miss Oregon that year, and everything fell apart right during that time. Thank God for things falling apart. And I was coming out of this relationship where, you know, I've been in adultery, he'd been in adultery, what have you. And the church I was going to, my ex-husband had slept with one of the girls in the church. And she was a friend of mine. Like, she was one of my friends. So it was a kind of a big mess. But I put on my wall that I wanted to forgive all the people who were attached to the situation because it was making me bitter. It was making me hard. It was messing with how I treated people. It was affecting me. And anybody that knew me could see there was a hardness on me because I really had dealt with that. So all of a sudden, I decided I wanted to forgive. So I put on my mirror like all these pictures. And by the time I knew it was pretty full, I was like, oh, thank God no police came in there because it looked like I was going to do something real bad. But I put all the pictures of them up. And so I have a boyfriend at the time, right? But I'm still married, right? But God is dealing with me. So I'm like, I can't have sex anymore. I was like, I can't have sex with you anymore. And I meant that. But he had just got moved back to from Chicago for me. And I had him staying at the house. He'd been there for like a week. So I'm like, well, you got to sleep on the couch. You know, I'm trying to, you know, I'm still not all right, you know. So I'm like, you got to sleep on the couch. I said, you got to get out. But yeah, but I said, you got to sleep on the couch and I can't have sex. And I was just like feeling, I want Jesus. I want Jesus. Something is missing. I can't do this anymore. Sex ain't good anymore. The money, the house, the cars, whatever. Nothing could fail this thing that was in me. And I could feel him pulling me. I needed him. So I start cutting stuff out because what you got right now, that's not good enough. It's not gonna get it with that craving that's in here. So I decided I'm gonna go forgive them. So I go to the church that I used to go to with the husband.